الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. All praise is due to Allah, Lord of all that exists, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon His final messenger Muhammad, His family and His companions.
وكان التوقف عند سورة المطففين.
So we are currently on the tafsir of سورة المطففين.
ومحور هذه السورة يدور حول اسم هذه السورة.
And the theme of this surah and its topics, they revolve around its name.
وهو التحذير من التطفيف.
And that is to beware of not doing something in full or not giving something its full measure.
ما محاور هذه السورة؟
What are the topics of this surah?
المحور الأول التحذير من التطفيف على وجه العموم.
The first topic is to beware of not giving something its full measure in general.
الأمر الثاني التحذير من التطفيف في الماديات.
Second topic is to beware of not giving something its full measure in materialistic issues.
المحور الثالث التحذير من التطفيف في إصدار الأحكام على الناس وفي القضاء بين الناس.
And the third topic is to beware of not giving full measure in terms of the way you judge between people.
المحور الرابع ثواب البار الحافظ الجميل الذي لا يطفف.
The fourth topic is the reward of the one who gives full accounting and he is good and honest in what he does.
المحور الخامس.
The fifth topic.
التحذير من التطفيف في التعامل مع الخلق.
To beware of not being giving full measure when dealing with other people.
المحور الأخير.
And the last topic.
ثواب المطفف المظلوم المطفف في حقه المظلوم.
The reward of the one who is being oppressed because he's not been giving his full due.
وان إذا أخذنا الآن بدأنا بالمحور الأول.
So let us go back to the first topic.
مقصد السورة التحذير من التطفيف.
The theme of the surah is to beware of not giving someone their full due or their measure.
المحور الأول.
The first topic.
التحذير من التطفيف على وجه العموم.
To beware of this in a general sense.
سواء في الماديات.
Whether that's in something which is tangible, you can touch.
أو في الأحكام والقضاء بين الناس.
Or whether it's to do with rulings and judgments.
أو في التعامل مع الناس.
Or in the way that you deal with people.
فوردت هذه الآية أول آية ويل للمطففين.
That is where Allah begins with the surah by saying, Woe to those who don't give full due and measure.
ما هو التطفيف؟
What is تطفيف؟
هو أن تأخذ من كيل غيرك ومن وزن غيرك لصالحك.
It is when you cheat someone out of their full due and measure for your own benefit.
ولكن شيئا طفيفا.
But it may just be a small amount that you take.
شيئا حقيرا.
It is something insignificant.
الله عز وجل حذر من هذا أن تأخذ الشيء الحقير.
But Allah warned us against what we consider to be insignificant.
وهو أن تأخذه ظلما.
And it is when you take it oppressively, it's not your right.
فإما أنك لا توفي حق المستحق.
So either you don't give someone their full right and their full due.
فتعطيه أقل من حقه.
And you give him less than what he deserves.
ولو أنك استأثرت نفسك بشيء يسير.
Even if you only withhold a small amount.
أو أنك تأخذ شيئا زائدا عن حقك.
Or that you take from someone else more than you deserve.
فلذا أتت هذه الآية ويل للمطففين.
And that is where Allah says, Woe to those who don't give full due and measure.
المحور الثاني.
The second topic.
احذر من التطفيف في الماديات الأمور المادية.
Beware of not giving someone their full due and measure in what is tangible.
وعقوبة هذا التطفيف.
And the what is the punishment of that.
وذلك بقول الله عز وجل.
And that is in the esteem of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
الذين إذا اكتالوا على الناس يستوفون.
Those people who when they take their due, they take it in full.
فيأخذ حقه كاملا.
He takes it in full.
وإذا كالوهم أعطوا الناس حقوقهم.
But when it is his turn to give others their due right.
أو سواء في الحجم أو في الوزن.
Or whether that's by volume or by mass.
يخسرون يعطونهم أقل من حقهم.
They don't give them their full due. They cheat them.
إذا قال الله عز وجل ألا يظن أولئك أنهم مبعوثون؟
So Allah says, do these people not think that they will be resurrected and accounted?
ألا يفكر باحتمال أنه يبعث؟
Doesn't even the concept of resurrection come across his mind of accounting?
باحتمال أنه يحاسب.
He doesn't even have the thought that perhaps he may be accounted.
باحتمال أنه يقوم بين يدي الله عز وجل.
He doesn't think that there's even a slight chance that he may have to stand before Allah.
هذا الاحتمال يجعلك لا تطفف.
Because even that slight possibility would stop you from not giving people their due rights.
فكيف إذا أيقنت بأنك ستبعث وتحاسب وتقف بين يدي الله عز وجل؟
But then what about when you know for surety, you know that for certainty you will stand before Allah and be accounted.
أنا أظن أولئك أنهم مبعوثون.
Do those people not think that they will stand before Allah, be resurrected before Him?
أولئك البعداء أنهم مبعوثون.
Those people who are distant and far away, they don't think that they will be resurrected.
ليوم عظيم.
On a day that is great.
يوم مخيف مرعب مهيب.
It is a day that is grave, a day that is terrifying.
يوم يقوم الناس لرب العالمين.
On the day that the people will stand before the Lord of the worlds.
فسيحكم عليهم عقوبة على ما حكموا به على الناس وطففوا.
And Allah will judge them for their unjust judgments upon other people.
يوم يقوم الناس عند مجيء الله عز وجل.
On the day that the people will stand when Allah comes before them.
فذكر الله عز وجل عقوبة التطفيف في الماديات.
And so Allah عز وجل mentioned the punishment of those who don't give full due and measure in tangible things.
أعطاه أقل من حقه بباوند أو بنص باوند.
Maybe all you took away from someone's right is 50 pence or 1 pound.
أعطاه أقل من حقه في الزيت في الذرة في القمح في الشعير.
Or when you're measuring someone and they buying from you wheat or barley or oil, you give them slightly less than what they asked for.
أو في الثوب أو في غير ذلك في أقل قليل أعطاه أقل من حقه.
Or in fruit, it's only a small amount that you took from them.
ما عقوبته؟
Or what is the punishment of that?
الله عز وجل كلا.
Allah عز وجل says nay.
عندما قال ألا يظن أولئك أنهم مبعوثون؟
When Allah said in the previous verse, as we said, Allah said, don't they think that they will be resurrected?
قال لا لا هؤلاء بعيدون حتى عن التفكير باحتمال أنه يبعثون يوم القيامة.
Allah says, nay, those people don't even think of the slight possibility that they may be resurrected.
قلوبهم بعيدة عن هذا التصور.
Because their thinking is far from this type of thing.
هم مكذبون بيوم البعث.
They are people who deny resurrection.
قال الله عز وجل في حق هؤلاء.
Allah says concerning those people.
إن كتاب الفجار لفي سجين هذا إنسان فاجر.
Indeed, the record of the fujjar is in سجين.
إخواني الفجور هو الخروج عن الطاعة والخروج عن أمر الصحيح.
Sin is when you disobey and you transgress beyond what is correct.
ولكنه يخرج بقوة وبكثرة.
But this is a person who does it often and does it vigorously.
أول يوم يطفف.
That first day he takes away from someone's rights.
ثم بعد ذلك يطفف ولو شيء يسير.
And then the second day he does it again even if it's small amount.
ثم يطفف.
And then he does it a third time.
فيستشري التطفيف في حقه.
And so this becomes his thing, his norm.
وإذا هذا إنسان فاجر.
And that's why Allah عز وجل considers this person to be a transgressor, an evil person.
كلا إن كتاب الفجار لفي سجين.
Allah says that indeed his scroll or his record will be in a سجين.
ما معنى سجين؟
And what is a سجين?
قال السجين كما قال الله عز وجل كتاب مرقوم أي كتاب كتبت فيه أسماء هؤلاء المجرمين المطففين.
It is a record that is transcribed with the names of these people who are the fujjar.
والكتاب هذا فيه أسماء المساجين بينهم سيسجنون.
And Allah عز وجل, and within it is the name of those people who will be imprisoned.
ويحبسون في حبس ضيق قالوا هذا هو السجن.
And they will be restricted upon and imprisoned.
فهؤلاء أسماء ما إدراك ما سجين كتاب مرقوم.
And that is why Allah says it is a registered, transcribed, inscribed.
وأنت لا تدرك عظم هذا الأمر وقبح هذا الكتاب.
And you don't understand how grave this matter is.
وقبح كذلك هذا السجن.
And the how grave this imprisonment will be.
ولذا قال عز وجل وما أدراك ما سجين.
And that is what Allah says. And how will you know what is a سجين?
كتاب مرقوم أي كتاب ترقم فيه وتسجل فيه أسماء هؤلاء المطففين المجرمين.
It is a register inscribed.
ويل يومئذ للمكذبين.
Woe on that day to those who denied.
وهذا إجابة على بيان لقول الله عز وجل السابق.
And this is an explanation of that previous verse.
كلا إنهم لا يظنون أنهم يبعثون يوم القيامة.
That those people never thought that they would be resurrected.
لما؟
Why?
لأنهم يكذبون بيوم الدين.
Because they deny resurrection.
قال ويل يومئذ للمكذبين.
That is why Allah says, woe on that day to those who deny resurrection.
الذين يكذبون بيوم الدين.
Those who deny the resurrection.
إذن هذا المحور الثاني.
This is the second topic.
وهو التحذير من التطفيف في الماديات.
And that is to beware of not giving full measure in what is tangible.
أتى المحور الثالث.
The third topic.
وهو النوع الثاني من التطفيف.
And that is the second type or the second form of not giving full measure and due.
التطفيف في إصدار الأحكام على الناس.
And that is when it comes to judgments and rulings between people.
والتطفيف في القضاء بين الناس.
In terms of the way that you judge between people.
التطفيف الأول إخواني وهو التطفيف في الماديات.
The first category that we mentioned of not giving full due in what is tangible.
يؤدي إلى التطفيف في الأحكام على الناس.
That leads a person to then not being just and not giving full due in the way that he judges between people.
ولذا سيكذب صاحب الحق.
And that is why that person will deny the rights of others.
ويحكم على صاحب الحق بأنه كذاب.
And he will say concerning his person, the person that is oppressing, he will say that he's a liar.
هذا التطفيف في الحكم على الناس.
And this is how you don't give full due and full measure in the way that you judge between people.
هذا أتى بصدق قال لا لا قال لا هذا يأتي بكذب.
That person who comes to take his rights, he's truthful. He wants his rights, but that person denies it and rejects him.
وهذا إشارة في حكمهم على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وتطفيفهم في حكمهم على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And this is a sign of how those people they would deny the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they would reject the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
الذين يكذبون بيوم الدين.
Those who deny the resurrection.
فكذبوا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الدعوة للإيمان بيوم الدين ويوم المحاسبة.
They denied the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and rejected him in his call to believe in the day of judgment.
وما يكذب به إلا كل ما يكذب يوم القيامة إلا كل معتد أثيم.
And Allah says, and those who deny the day of judgment are only those who are transgressive and sinful.
لما الله عز وجل وصفه بأنه معتد.
Why did Allah describe these people as being transgressive?
لأنه تعدى في الحكم القضائي وحكم على كلام فلان بأنه كذاب وأنه يكذب.
Because this is a person who oversteps the bounds and he transgresses when he calls others liars.
وهو أثيم أي منهمك بالإثم.
And he's someone who is always sinful.
إذا تتلى عليه آياتنا قال أساطير الأولين.
When our verses are recited to him, he says that these are the tales of old.
فحكم على القرآن بأنه أساطير الأولين.
This is his judgment of the Quran, that the Quran is a tale from the times of old.
فطفف في حكمه على القرآن.
And so he was unjust. He didn't give the Quran its full due and right.
هذا التطفيف في الأحكام على الغيب في إصدار الأحكام على الغيب.
And this is how that person doesn't give full right and measure when it comes to rulings and judgments.
يقول القرآن ما هو إلا أباطيل وقصص كلها باطلة سابقة هكذا.
He says that the Quran is just stories and tales.
الله عز وجل كلا هذا القول باطل.
And then Allah again says nay, that is incorrect, that speech.
قوله القرآن أساطير الأولين هذا قول باطل كلا.
That claim that the Quran is only tales of old is false.
من الذي قادهم إلى هذا الحكم أن حكموا على القرآن بهذا؟
What led that person to go to that stage where this is the ruling or the judgment he gave concerning the Quran?
ما قادهم إلى هذا إلا أنه قد غلف قلوبهم أو غلفت قلوبهم السيئات والعياذ بالله والذنوب التي ارتكبوها.
What led them to this result is that their hearts were covered by sin and they were concealed by sin.
قلوبهم مغلفة بغلاف سميك.
Their hearts are covered by a strong sheet or a strong cover.
لا يستقبل الحق.
It won't allow the truth to penetrate.
بسبب ما كسبوه من الذنوب.
Because of the evil and the sins that they've performed.
وإذا قال عز وجل بل أي ما قادهم إلى هذا ران على قلوبهم ما كان يكسب.
And that is why Allah says, rather that which they used to do of evil has covered their hearts.
كلا إنهم عن ربهم يومئذ لمحجوبون.
And that is why Allah then says, but on that day and the day of judgment they will be veiled and screened from Allah.
عندما قالوا أساطير الأولين كلا.
Their claim again that the Quran is tales of old, Allah rejects it again.
أي كلامهم هذا باطل في حكمه بأنهم أساطير الأولين.
That their assertion, that claim is false of theirs.
وإنهم عقوبة على ذلك سيحجبون عن رؤية الله عز وجل يوم
القيامة. And as a punishment for that claim, Allah will veil himself from them, screen himself from them on the day of judgment.
كما احتجبهم عن أصحاب الحقوق عندما طالبوا بحقوقهم.
Just as they screened themselves off from those people who wanted their rights from them.
لأن الناس يوم القيامة الله لأن المؤمنين يوم القيامة يرون الله عز وجل في أرض المحشر.
Because the believers they will see Allah on the day of judgment.
أما هؤلاء المعرضون عن التوحيد يحتجب الله عز وجل عنهم.
Whereas for those people who turn away from Allah's tawheed, Allah will screen Himself from them, veil Himself from them.
عقوبة لهم.
As a punishment for them.
ثم إنهم لصالوا الجحيم.
And then those people they will be taken to the fire.
أي الله عز وجل يحتجب عنهم في أرض المحشر.
Just as Allah screens Himself from them on the day of judgment.
وطول هذا اليوم 50,000 سنة.
On a day its length is 50,000 years.
بعد هذه المرحلة.
After that stage.
سيصلون الجحيم.
They will be led to the fire.
وإذا قال عز وجل ثم أي للتراخي بعد فترة بعد 50 عاما.
And that is why Allah says then, meaning after that period of time, they will be led to the fire.
ثم يقال هذا الذي كنتم به تكذبون.
And then it will be said to them, this is what you denied and rejected.
بسبب جوركم وتطفيفكم أن حكمتم على ما قاله النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بالكذب.
And it is because you never gave things their full right and measure that you rejected what the Prophet ﷺ brought.
وما كذبتم به كذبتم القرآن وكذبتم كذلك الإيمان بالبعث ووقوع يوم البعث يوم القيامة.
And not only did you reject the Quran, but you also rejected and denied resurrection.
هذا النوع الثاني من التطفيف وهو المحور الثالث.
And this is the second category or the second type of not giving something its full rights and dues.
المحور الرابع.
The fourth topic.
ثواب البار الحافظ الجميل الذي لا يطفف.
The reward of the one who is honest and fulfilling the rights of others.
كلا إن كتاب الأبرار لفي عليين.
Allah says, rather the register of the abrar of the righteous will be in عليين.
في قول أولئك أساطير عن القرآن أساطير الأولين.
Because those people claim that the Quran was tales of old.
كلا كلامهم باطل.
Again, Allah once again says that claim is false.
وسيرون بأن كتاب الأبرار في عليين.
And they will see that the register of the righteous will be in عليين.
ومن هو البار؟
And who is the one who is dutiful?
هو الذي أدى كل ما عليه.
He is the one who fulfills all his rights.
واتسع في طاعة من أكرمه ومن قدم له الجميل.
And he is the one who is dutiful to the one who and is obedient to the one who did good towards him.
وتعامل بغاية الإحسان من قدم له الجميل.
And he is extremely good to the one who does good towards him.
فقال الله عز وجل أسماء هؤلاء أسماء الأبرار لفي عليين.
And that is why Allah says that their names will be recorded in عليين.
وما هو عليون؟ قال وما عليون؟
And Allah then said, and how will you know what is عليون?
كتاب مرقوم.
It is a register inscribed.
كتاب كتبت فيه أسماء هؤلاء البارين.
A register in which the names of those people is inscribed.
وكتب فيه كذلك جزاء هؤلاء البارين.
And likewise, their reward will be inscribed therein.
وأين موقع هذا الكتاب؟
And where is this register kept?
في الدرجات العلى في عليين أي في العلو.
It will be kept in the highest of levels.
وإذا قال الله عز وجل وما أدراك ما عليون كتاب مرقوم.
And that is why Allah says that what will allow you to know what is عليون, it is a register inscribed.
تشهد الملائكة كتابة أسماء هؤلاء الأبرار.
The angels will bear witness to the inscription of the names of those righteous people.
يشهده المقربون.
Allah says it will be borne witness by those who are close to Him.
ما جزاؤهم؟
What is their reward?
هؤلاء الأبرار إن الأبرار لفي نعيم.
Allah says that they will be in bliss.
يتنعمون هؤلاء.
They will be blissful.
على الأرائك.
They will be reclining on couches.
والأرائك هي الفرش التي عليها القبب من القماش.
And an araik is the couch that has a canopy over it.
الأرائك ينظرون إلى الله.
They will be reclining therein, looking towards their Lord.
فإذا نظروا إلى الله ازدادت وجوههم نضارة.
And as they come closer to their Lord, they will become more radiant in their faces.
عكس أولئك الذين حجبوا عن الله عز وجل.
And they will be then the opposite of those people who were screened from Allah and veiled from Him.
تعرف في وجوههم النظار نظرة النعيم.
You will see in their faces the radiance of their bliss.
يسقون من رحيق مختوم.
They will drink from the sealed nectar.
والرحيق قيل هو صفوة الخمر.
It is said that this رحيق it is the best type of wine.
وخالص الخمر.
And it is the purest form.
لا غش فيه.
There is no impurity in it.
طيب الرائحة.
It is extremely pleasant in its scent.
طيب الطعم.
And delicious to taste.
وقال بعضهم لونه أبيض أي الخمر الأبيض.
And others said that it will be white in color.
هذا الرحيق وهذا الخمر مختوم.
Clear in color.
مختوم ما معنى مختوم؟
And what is مختوم?
أي
sealed.
معتق.
that it is sealed.
لم تمسه اليد.
Meaning that it has never been touched before.
ولم يفتح قبل ذلك.
And it's never been opened before.
وإذا قال مختوم أي عليه ختم.
And that is why it is said that it is sealed.
والآن ربما أصحاب الخمور يشترون الخمور معتقة ربما بالمئات ربما بالآلاف.
Just as today people will buy certain types of alcohol that have been sealed from decades before. It's worth a lot of money. It's expensive.
أين هذا من رحيق المختوم في الجنة؟
But how does that compare to what Allah has prepared of the sealed nectar?
ختامه مسك أي في نهاية الكأس هذا مسك.
At the very end of that drink is musk.
وأحيانا الإنسان عندما يشرب الشراب يكون في نهاية الشراب فيه شيء من الخلط وشيء من الكدر.
Normally, when we have some drinks, you look towards the end of that drink, at the bottom of it, there's like normally remnants that are left that people don't like.
هذا ختامه أفضل من أوله.
But this one, this drink of Jannah, its ending is better than its beginning.
وفي ذلك فليتنافس المتنافسون.
And that is why Allah said, then let people compete for this.
ومزاجه من تسنيم.
And it will be mixed with تسنيم.
ما هو التسنيم؟
What is تسنيم؟
قال يقيل هو إضافة يضاف على الخمر.
It is said that in addition to that wine that they will drink,
بحيث ترى فيه علو وترى فيه كأن فيه نوع من العلو. يعني أحيانا الخمر يتسابق أهل الخمر بأن يكون الخمر عندما يصب يكون فيه نوع من الزباد فيه شيء من العلو.
People in their drinks, they like, for example, that froth that comes at the top of that alcohol.
فالله عز وجل يخبر عن خمر الجنة.
So Allah عز وجل says concerning the wine of Jannah.
يمزج بشراب.
It will be mixed with another drink.
من شراب آخر من الخمر.
That is also made from wine.
يجعل له ارتفاع ولذا سماه بالسنام تسنيم أي كأنه سنام على هذا الخمر.
And it will be so that froth of it will be made from another pure drink.
هذا للمؤمنين.
This is for the believers.
ماذا عن المحسنين؟
What about for those who are the best of them or the righteous, the most righteous of them?
يشربون شرابا صرفا من التسنيم من هذا المزاج.
They will drink only from تسنيم.
ولذا الله عز وجل قال عينا يشرب بها المقرب.
And that is why Allah said that it will be a spring that those who are closest to Him will drink from.
هذا المحور الرابع.
This is the fourth topic.
وهو جزاء البار الذي لم يطفف.
It is the reward of the person who was righteous and he didn't withhold any due right or measure.
المحور الخامس.
The fifth topic.
وهو النوع الثالث من التطفيف وهو التطفيف في التعامل مع الناس.
And that is the third type of withholding full right and measure or due right and measure, and that is when people do it in their relationships and in the way they interact with others.
احذر من التطفيف في التعامل مع الناس.
So beware of not giving people their full right in the way that you deal with them.
لا تستهزئ بأصحاب المروءة. لا تستهزئ بالناس.
Don't mock and ridicule people.
لا تطفف في تعاملك مع الناس.
And don't withhold people's rights in the way that you deal with them.
وكلما كان الطرف الآخر صاحب مروءة كان الاستهزاء به والتطفيف بالتعامل معه أشد وأجرم.
And the more righteous that person is, the worse that it is that you don't give them their full rights.
وإذا قال الله عز وجل.
And that is why Allah said.
إن الذين أجرموا أصحاب الجناية والجريمة والذنب العظيم.
Indeed, those who are criminals and evil.
كانوا من الذين آمنوا يضحكون.
They would ridicule the believers.
كانوا يطففون في التعامل معهم.
Because they used to not be just in the way that they used to deal with them.
يحتقرونهم يستهزئون بهم.
But they would belittle them and they would ridicule them.
إن الذين أجرموا كانوا من الذين آمنوا يضحكون.
Indeed, those who were evil, they used to make fun of the believers.
وإذا مروا بهم يتغامزون بالجفون أو بالإشارات أو بالعيون.
And when they would pass by them, they would look at them or make derisive glances towards them.
وإذا انقلبوا رجع هؤلاء الكفار إلى أهليهم انقلبوا فكهين.
And when they would return to their families, those disbelievers, they would return mocking and jesting them.
أي يضحكون على أولئك المؤمنين.
They would laugh at them.
مترفهينهم.
And they would ridicule them.
وإذا رأوا أهل الإيمان وأهل الصلاة قال إن هؤلاء لضالون.
And when they would look towards the believers, they would say, these are the misguided people.
في أتباع النبي يقول هذا في أتباع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Meaning referring to the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ضيعوا حياتهم بالصلاة.
Because they would say these people are wasting their time and their lives in prayer.
ضيعوا شبابهم في حفظ القرآن.
And they're wasting their youth in memorizing the Quran.
ضيعوا شبابهم في حضور الدروس.
And they're wasting their youth in attending lectures.
فهلا ذهبوا إلى المراقص وإلى أماكن البار وإلى إلى إلى مكان شرب الخمر
Why don't they enjoy their lives by going to bars and clubs instead? And so that's why they caused or they thought them to be astray. And so they weren't just in the way that they dealt with them. What will be their recompense on the Day of Judgment? That is the final topic of this surah. And that is that the one who was oppressed in this way, Allah will give him his full reward. Because on the Day of Judgment, the tables will be turned. Allah says, on that day, the believers will laugh at the disbelievers whilst they are reclining upon those couches. And Allah will say, were those disbelievers not given their due and full recompense for that which they used to do?
مقصد سورة المطففين.
So this is the theme of سورة المطففين.
لا تطفف في الحكم على أصحاب التوحيد وفي التعامل مع أهل التوحيد.
Don't withhold the rights and the due full measure of the people of توحيد.
فإن هذا مهما أخفيته ستكشف الستور يوم القيامة وتفضح أنت يوم القيامة.
Because no matter how much you try to hide this on the day of judgment, it will be exposed.
فإن يوم القيامة ستكشف الستور وتظهر جميع الأعمال.
Because Allah will expose everything on the day of judgment and everything will be open and apparent.
وهذا مقصد سورة الانشقاق.
And this is now then, or this point is now then the theme of سورة الانشقاق, the next surah.
إذن سورة الانشقاق مقصدها ستكشف الستور.
And so the theme of Surah Al-Inshiqaq is that those veils or those blinds will be drawn back. And everything will become apparent on the Day of Judgment even if you hid it in this world. What are the topics of this surah?
المحور الأول إخواني ستكشف جميع الستور في الكون.
The first topic is that all of the universe, all of its veils will be lifted on that day. And everything that was hidden and unveiled on that day will become apparent and open. The second topic. A person, all of the actions of the people that they performed in this life will be unveiled. And they will be recompensed for them. The third topic.
مهما أخفى الإنسان من عمل في ظلمة الليل فإنه مكشوف عند الله.
No matter how much a person tries to hide something in the darkness of the night, it is known and apparent to Allah.
المحور الخامس الرابع.
The fourth topic.
القسم بأن الإنسان سينتقل من مرحلة إلى مرحلة لتكشف ستوره.
The promise of Allah that a person will go from one stage to the next stage until all of their affairs are open.
المحور الخامس.
The fifth topic.
إذا كانت الأمور ستكشف إذن علامة الإعراض عن التوحيد.
If everything will become apparent and placed in the open, then why turn away from Tawheed?
المحور السادس.
The sixth topic.
الجزاء.
The recompense of this.
للمؤمنين والكفار.
Whether for the believers or the disbelievers.
لمن أقبل على التوحيد ولمن أعرض عن التوحيد.
Whether it's for the people who turn towards Tawheed or the recompense of the people who turn away from Tawheed.
نأتي الآن إخواني إلى المحاور إلى بيان المحاور.
So now let us go to each one of those topics.
مقصد السورة ستكشف الستور.
The theme of this surah is that all of these veils will be lifted.
وتظهر الأعمال.
And all of the actions will become apparent.
نأتي المحور الأول.
The first topic.
ستكشف الستور في الكون كله.
Is that in the universe all of these veils will be lifted.
ويظهر ما كان خافيا.
And everything that was hidden in this world will become apparent.
إذا السماء انشقت.
Allah Azza wa Jal says when the heavens are rent asunder.
تصدعت وتفرقت.
Meaning that they will open up and they will come apart.
وأذنت أي استمعت وأطاعت وأذنت لربها وحقت وجب عليها أن تطيع الله عز وجل.
And it will be dutiful, meaning the heavens will listen to the command of Allah in that regard and it must do so.
فإذا انشقت ظهر ما كان خافيا وراءها.
Because if the heavens are opened up or they're rent asunder, they're broken apart, then you will see what is behind them.
ولذا تظهر الملائكة وتنزل الملائكة.
And that is when the people will see the angels descending.
فإذا ما كان خافيا وراء السماء سيظهر.
So that which was hidden behind the heavens will become open and apparent.
وإذا الأرض مدت.
And then Allah says, and when the earth is made flat,
استطالت وانبسطت.
It will be expanded and made extensive.
واتسعت هذه الأرض.
And it will be widened.
فألقت كشفت كل ما خفي تحتها.
And it will bring forth everything that was hidden within it.
وألقت ما فيها.
And it will throw out everything within it.
الناس فيها القبور كلها تظهر.
Meaning all of the people hidden within it in their graves, all of them will come out.
وكذلك البراكين ما تخفيها من ذهب ومن ثروات كلها تخرجها.
And all of its treasures and precious stones that it was hiding will also be apparent.
وتبرأت منهم وتخلت عنهم.
And it will remove everything from it.
وخلى ما في جوفها. وإذا قال تخلت أي خلك كل ما في جوفها.
And everything within the depths of the earth will be taken from it, taken out of it.
أذنت لربها أي استمعت وأطاعت ربها.
And that is because the earth will also listen to the command of its Lord in that regard.
وحق لها أي وجب عليها أن تطيع أمر ربها.
And it is incumbent upon it. It is obligatory upon it to listen to Allah.
بأن تتصدع وكذا السماء بأن تنشق.
And that the earth should expose everything within it, and likewise the heavens.
كل ذلك استماعا واستجابة للأوامر الإلهية.
All of that in response to Allah's commands.
إذا كان الأمر كذلك، إذن لم يصبح لا يصبح لا يبقى شيء خافية.
And if that's the case, then there will be nothing left or remaining that is hidden.
فكل شيء مكشوف ظاهر.
Because everything will be open and apparent.
إذن هذا المحور الأول.
This is the first topic.
المحور الثاني.
The second topic.
ستكشف كذلك جميع أعمال المكلفين.
The actions of the people will also be made apparent.
التي عملوها في الدنيا.
Meaning the actions that they performed in this world.
وسيجازون عليها يوم القيامة.
And they will be given their full recompense for them on the day of judgment.
يا أيها الإنسان.
O man, O mankind.
إنك كادح إلى ربك كدحا فملاق. إنك ساعيا باجتهاد ستسعى. باجتهاد في هذه الدنيا وستلاقي هذا الاجتهاد.
You are toiling towards your Lord bit or stage after stage and you will until you meet him.
سواء كنت ساعيا الى الله موحدا.
Whether you're toiling towards him with توحيد of him.
وعملت باجتهاد.
And you're doing that and you're working towards him.
او كنت ساعيا من اجل هذه الدنيا معرضا عن الله عز وجل.
Or you're toiling for the life of this world and you're turning away from Allah عز وجل.
كل هذا ستلاقيه يوم القيامة.
All of this you will find on the day of judgment.
سيكون مكشوفا بعدما كان خافيا.
And it will be made apparent after it was hidden.
وستكشف لك جميع اعمالك.
And all of your actions will be laid bare.
الآن إذا كشفت الاعمال اما موحد او معرض عن التوحيد.
Because now, when those actions are made apparent, there are only two types of people: those who believe and those who disbelieve.
فهذا الموحد يعطى كتابه بيمينه.
So as for the one who believed, he will be given his record of deeds in his right hand.
وهذا الكتاب كتابه أعماله.
And this is the record of his deeds.
فأما من أوتي كتابه بيمينه.
And that is where Allah says, and as for those who are given their record with their right hand, in their right hand, then that person will be given an easy reckoning. It will be just a presentation and Allah will forgive him for everything. Allah won't hold him to account and start debating him on every single point and issue. But rather he will be given his record in his right hand and be given an easy accounting. And so he will be given his result also in his right hand. So he will return to his family happy. As Allah says, he will return to them happy. To his family in Jannah. Whether that's his family that are in Jannah from this life or the family that he will be given in the next life. As for the one whose actions are unveiled and he wasn't from the people of Tawheed and he wasn't from the people of obedience to Allah, he will be given his record of deeds in the left hand. And he will be given a difficult reckoning.
وإذا حوسب حسابا عسيرا يناقش في كل صغيرة وكبيرة.
And a difficult reckoning means that Allah will stop him and pull him up on every single issue and point.
فيعطى بعد ذلك كتاب النتيجة.
And he will then be given his result.
ويعطى كتاب النتيجة يعطى كتاب النتيجة بشماله كذلك.
And his result will also be given to him in his left hand.
ولكن من وراء ظهره.
From behind his back in his left hand.
عقوبة له لا يستحق هذا.
Because that will be a form of punishment for him that is undeserving. And it is a form of humiliation for him. So So Allah says, and as for the one who's given his record of deeds from behind his back, he will call upon himself with destruction. And he will say, woe to me. And he will cry out in remorse. And he will be led to the fire.
إنه كان في أهله مسرورا معرضا ناسيا بعيدا عن الله.
Allah says that person in this life they used to be happy in their family, negligent of Allah.
متبعا هواه.
Following his desires.
لا يبالي في عصيانه وفي فجوره.
Not caring about disobeying Allah.
إنه كان في أهله مسرورا إنه ظن أن لا يحور ظن أن لا يعود وأن لا يبعث يوم القيامة.
Because he thought that he would never have to return to his Lord.
وأنه لا يحاسب ولا يعاقب.
And that he won't be accounted and won't be judged.
بلى سيحور.
Allah says, but rather the reality is that he will be judged and he will be taken back to Allah.
إن ربه كان به بصير أعماله مكشوفة عند الله عز وجل.
For his Lord was all aware of him and his actions were not hidden from Allah.
فأقسم الله عز وجل بأن الجميع سيمر في هذه المراحل.
And so Allah عز وجل, he takes an oath that every person will go through these stages.
فلا أقسم بالشفق.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I take an oath by the twilight.
والليل وما وسق وما اجتمع فيه.
And the night and everything it gathers.
والقمر إذا اتسق أصبح بدرا.
And the moon when it becomes full.
لتركبن طبقا عن طبق كما أخبرناكم.
You will pass by each one of the stage by stage.
وتمر في مرحلة الشباب فتعمل أعمالا.
Because you will be a youth and you will do certain deeds. Actions will be exposed.
وتنتقب عليك إلى أرض جديدة.
And then you will go to this new land of gathering.
وتحاسب على أعمالك.
And you will be held to account for your deeds.
ثم تمر على الصراط.
And then you will go upon the bridge.
ثم إلى جنة أو إلى نار.
And either your destination will be paradise or the fire.
لتمرن على جميع هذه المراحل.
So you will have to go past each of these stages.
وكل ذلك تجازى على الأعمال التي كنت قمت بها وظهرت كذاك.
And all of this as a result of the actions that you performed in this world.
الآن نأتي إخواني المحور الثالث.
The third topic of this surah.
يأتي السؤال لماذا الله عز وجل أقسم بالشفق؟
Why the question here may pose itself? Why did Allah take an oath in this surah by the night?
لما لم يقسم يقسم بالشمس؟
Why not take an oath by the sun?
لما لم يقسم كسائر الصور الأخرى أقسم الله عز وجل بعدة مخلوقات؟
Why not take an oath by the other things that Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned throughout the Quran that he takes an oath by?
لمن يقسم بالتين والزيتون وطور سينين في هذا الموضوع؟
Why didn't Allah Azza wa Jalla take an oath by the fig and the olive in this surah as he did in Surah At-Tin?
لكن أقسم بالشفق.
But rather Allah chose the twilight, the night.
لأن إخواني الشفق نهاية النهار.
Because the twilight or that time is the time just before sunset.
غربت الشمس فبقي شيء من أشعة الشمس.
The sun sets, but some of the light, the remnants of the light of the sun still remain in the sky.
وهذه بداية الخفاء.
And this is the beginning of the night and the beginning of concealment.
ولذا قال الشفق.
And that is why it is called the shafaq.
قال في الخفاء أبدأ بأن أعمل أعمال المحرمة.
Because there are people who think when the night comes, they are more likely to sin and disobey Allah in night and darkness.
يخفي أعماله السيئة هنا.
Because they use the night to hide their evil.
ثم إذا أظلم الليل.
And then when the night, the darkness of the night fully comes.
والليل وما وسق.
And Allah Azza wa Jalla says, and the night and that which it conceals.
قال بعضهم إذا اشتدت ظلمة الليل.
Meaning that when the night becomes fully dark.
حينئذ يكثر والعياذ بالله من المفاسد في هذه.
That is when that person goes and he does as much evil as he wants.
يظن نفسه بأن قد أخفى أعماله عن.
Because he thinks that darkness will veil him.
وإذا قال الله عز وجل والليل وما وسق.
And that is why Allah says, and the night and what it conceals.
وكذلك قال ما وسق أي ما جمع من الأعمال.
Meaning and everything he gathers of his actions that night.
شرب خمر.
Drinking. Women.
زنا.
قمار. Gambling.
شتم. كل هذه الأمور يفعلها في الليل.
Swearing. Everything he does during the night.
والليل وما وسق من أعمال السيئة.
So Allah says in the night and what he gathers in that night of evil.
في مقابل أهل الطاعة.
As for the people of righteousness.
قيام الليل.
They are the ones who sleep the night.
وذكر.
They spend their night in worship and in dhikr.
وتذاكر فيما بينهم. وتذاكر فيما بينهم.
And they spend their nights revising with one another,
وقراءة,
reminding one another.
وقراءة وتأليف.
And reading and writing.
هؤلاء جمعوا الطاعة وأولئك جمعوا السيئات.
That group uses the night to worship Allah, and this group uses the night to disobey Allah.
الله عز وجل قال هذه المخلوقات في الليل.
Allah said that these creations during the night.
يكشفها القمر إذا كان بدرا.
The full moon, when the moon becomes full, it gives light and it lights up everything.
أما يكشفها الله عز وجل؟
So if the moon can shed light upon the night, then can't Allah عز وجل do more?
الناس في ظهور البدر يكشفون هذه الأعمال فلان يعمل كذا فلان إذا ظهر القمر وظهر البدر.
When the night or the full moon comes on, everyone can see what people are doing during the night. There's no hiding.
فأعمال الناس تغيب عن الله عز وجل.
So do you think therefore that your actions can be hidden from Allah?
سواء كان بدرا أم لم يكن بدرا.
Whether the full the moon is full or not full.
ولذا الله عز وجل ذكر هذه الآيات بعد أن قال بلى إن ربه كان به بصيرا.
And that is where Allah سبحانه وتعالى mentioned this after saying indeed your Lord is all aware.
فإذا هنا هذا المحور الثالث.
This is the third topic.
مهما أخفى الإنسان من عمل في ظلمة الليل فإنه مكشوف عند الله تعالى.
No matter how much a person tries to hide their deeds in the middle of the night, it is known to Allah.
المحور الرابع.
The fourth topic.
القسم بأن العبد سينتقل من مرحلة إلى مرحلة.
It is the oath that Allah takes that a person will pass from one stage to the next stage.
وكل مرحلة أعظم كشفا من سابقتها.
And every stage that you come across will expose you more than the previous stage.
في القبر ستظهر أعمالك أظهر مما كنت في الدنيا.
The stage of the grave will expose you more than the stage of this life exposed you.
تكشف لك الأعمال وأنت في قبرك.
You will see your deeds in your grave.
ربما تكون أنت نسيتها في الدنيا ومخفية.
Maybe some of those deeds were hidden from people and maybe you forgot them yourself in this life.
يأتيه عمله.
His actions will come to him.
في صورة رجل قبيح.
In the form of a man who is ugly.
رائحته قبيحة.
And his scent, his odor is ugly.
يقول له من أنت؟
And the man will say, or the person in the grave will say, who are you?
قال أنا أعملك السيء.
And he will reply, I am your evil deeds.
بينما المؤمن.
Whereas the believer.
يأتيه عمله.
His actions will come
على شكل رجل
also in the form of a man
جميل الوجه
but one who is beautiful
طيب الرائحة
one who has a beautiful scent
من أنت
and when he asks who are you
قال أنا أعملك الصالح
he will reply I am your good deeds
ففي قبره تظهر أعماله أكثر من دنياه
so in the grave your actions are more exposed than they were in this world
هذا الطبقة الثانية المرحلة الثانية
this is the second stage of a person's existence
المرحلة الثالثة يوم القيامة
the third stage is the day of judgment
ستظهر له أعماله أكثر مما رآها في قبره
and those actions will be further exposed on the day of judgment even more so than they were in the grave
ولذا قال الله عز وجل بعدما أقسم في الأمور السابقة
And that is where Allah says, after taking those oaths that we mentioned,
لَتَرْكَبُنَّ طَبَقًا عَنْ طَبَقٍ
You will pass by stage to stage.
فَلَنْ يَخْفَى شَيْءٍ عَنْ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ
Because nothing can remain hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وَلَا كَذَلِكَ سَتَخْفَى عَنْكَ هَذِي الْأَعْمَالِ الَّتِي قُمْتَ بِهَا فِي قَبْرِكَ وَلَا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ
And nor will they be hidden from you in your grave or the day of judgment.
المحور الخامس
The fifth topic.
بعدما تبين هذا
Once this is known
بأن أعمالك ستظهر
That your actions will be exposed.
وكل مرحلة تظهر أكثر من سابقتها وأظهر من سابقتها.
And that every stage that exposure is greater than the previous stage.
علام الإعراض عن توحيد الله.
Then the question is why turn away from Allah's tawheed?
فما لهم لا يؤمنون.
And that is why Allah says. So then, what is wrong with these people that they don't believe?
استفهام هذا إنكار عليهم.
It is a rhetorical question upon them.
نعم لا يؤمنون بأنهم كفر ويكذبون.
They don't believe because they deny all of this and they reject it.
وإذا قرئ عليهم القرآن لا ما لهم إذا قرئ عليهم القرآن لا يسجدون.
And Allah asks and why when the Quran is recited to them they don't prostrate.
لأنهم يكذبون بيوم الدين.
Because they disbelieve in the day of judgment.
بل الذين كفروا يكذبون.
But rather and then Allah says rather those who disbelieve they deny.
يكذبونه ظاهرا.
They deny and reject it openly apparently.
يعلمون بأنه حق.
But internally in their hearts they know that it is the truth.
قال الله عز وجل.
And that is what Allah says.
والله أعلم بما يعون الله عز وجل يعلم بما في قلوبهم وما في عقولهم من أن هذا الأمر حق.
Allah knows what they conceal because in their hearts and in their minds they know that it is the truth.
ويعلم بما يضمرونه.
And Allah knows what they conceal.
ويعلم بأنه قد اجتمعت البراهين على صحة ما جاء به النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وصحة هذا القرآن.
And they know that the evidences show the truthfulness of the Quran and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ولكن اجتمعت في قلوبهم حب الرئاسة.
But rather in their hearts they want power.
والخصومة.
And they want to be opponents.
والحسد والعناد.
And they have jealousy and envy and hatred.
والكبر.
And they are arrogant.
وسيظهر هذا يوم القيامة.
And all of this will be exposed on the day of judgment.
لأن كل شيء سيكشف.
Because everything will be exposed on that day.
فبشرهم هذا المحور السادس.
And this is the sixth, now the sixth topic.
فبشرهم بعذاب أليم.
So give them the tidings of a painful punishment.
هذا جزاء الكفار.
Because that is the punishment of the disbelievers.
بين الموحد لله عز وجل.
Because the one who has, as for the one who has توحيد of Allah.
إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات.
Allah says, except for those who believe and do righteous deeds.
لهم أجر غير ممنون.
They will have a reward that has no ending.
كل شيء إذن سيكشف.
So therefore, everything will be exposed.
فكل عبد يوم القيامة فاضح ومفضوح.
So every person on the day of judgment will be exposed.
أتت سورة البروج.
And that is why we have the next surah, سورة البروج.
هذا مقصدها.
This is the theme of سورة البروج.
أن كل عبد فاضح ومفضوح يوم القيامة.
And that is that every servant will be exposed on the day of judgment.
إذا عرفنا مقصد سورة البروج.
So this is the theme of سورة البروج.
المحور الأول.
The first topic of سورة البروج.
المقدمة وهي البروج فاضحة للمخلوقات والمخلوقات فاضحة لها.
The buruj, which are the constellations, the stars, they are apparent to the people, and the people are apparent to them.
المحور الثاني.
The second topic.
العباد يوم القيامة.
The people on the day of judgment.
فاضحون لأعمال غيرهم.
They will be exposed one to another. The actions will be exposed to one another.
يشاهدون أعمال غيرهم.
They will see the actions of others.
فهم فاضحون لأعمال غيرهم.
And so they will be exposed. The actions will be exposed.
وكذلك جزاءات غيرهم ستكون مفضوحة لديهم.
And likewise, the end result, the reward, or the punishment of others will also be exposed to them.
وأعمالهم كذلك هي مفضوحة عند غيرهم.
And their own actions are also exposed. They will see what others will see what they have.
المحور الثالث.
The third topic.
وإذا قال الله عز وجل في المحور الثاني.
And that is where Allah said, beginning that second topic.
واليوم الموعود وشاهد ومشهود.
And the promised day and the witnessed and what is witnessed.
تشاهد يوم القيامة أعمال غيرك فتكون مفضوحة لديك.
You will see on the day of judgment the actions of others and they will be exposed.
وتشاهد جزاءاتهم.
And you will see their reward or their punishment.
وأنت مشهود كذلك من قبل غيرك.
And others will witness the same for you.
المحور الثالث.
The third topic.
أصحاب الأخدود بين كونهم شاهدين ومشهودين.
The people of the trench were between those two groups, those who were witnesses and those who were witnessed upon. Allah says they were killed, the people of the trench. The fourth topic. The recompense of Allah Azza wa Jalla, His reckoning, will be witnessed in this life and in the next. The fifth topic.
الشهود الأخروي أعظم من الشهود الدنيوي. الفضيحة الأخروية أعظم من الفضيحة الدنيوية.
The exposure of the next life is far worse than the exposure of this life.
المحور السادس.
The sixth topic.
الجميع مفضوح عند الله عز وجل.
Everyone is exposed in front of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
أخذنا إخواني المحور الأول.
The first topic.
عرفنا مقصد السورة.
So now we know the theme of this surah.
كل عبد فاضح ومفضوح يوم القيامة.
Every person will be exposed. They will see others exposed, and they will be exposed themselves on the day of judgment.
المحور الأول.
The first topic.
البروج إخواني فاضحة للخلق.
The constellations, the stars, they are also exposed to people.
وهي مفضوحة لديهم.
And they. People are exposed to them.
ولذا الله عز وجل قال أقسم بالبروج.
And that is why Allah عز وجل began this surah by taking an oath by them.
والسماء ذات البروج.
He said by the heavens and their constellations.
والبروج هي منازل النجوم.
And they are the constellations of the stars.
تقول هذا برج الأسد، هذا برج الثور، هذا برج الحمل، هذه البروج.
You know the different constellations of the stars and the animal names that are given to them.
مكشوفة لدى الناس، الناس يرونها.
And so people can see those constellations.
ومن كان عليها على هذا البروج يرى من تحته فالناس مكشوفون عندهم كذلك.
And likewise from the constellations or stars, everyone beneath them is seen and exposed.
فابتدأت الصورة بالبيان بأن كل شيء فاضح ومفضوح.
And so the surah begins with the statement that everything is exposed. You are exposed and it is exposed.
هذا في الدنيا.
That is in this life.
كذلك يوم القيامة.
And the same will be on the day of judgment.
والفضيحة أكبر.
But rather that exposure will be great, greater.
قال الله عز وجل واليوم الموعود.
And that is why Allah then took an oath by the promised day.
هذا المحور الثاني.
And this is the second topic.
العباد يوم القيامة.
That the people on the day of judgment,
شاهدون لأعمال غيرهم.
They will witness the actions of others.
وعقوبة وجزاءات غيرهم.
And they will see the reward, their rewards and their punishments.
وغيرهم كذلك شاهدون وفاضحون لأعمال هؤلاء العباد.
And others will be bear witness and they will witness the exposure of our deeds.
فأقسم الله عز وجل باليوم الموعود وهو يوم القيامة.
And that is why Allah took an oath by the promised day, and that is the day of judgment. And then Allah took an oath by the witness and what is witness, because everyone is either a witness or they are witnessed upon.
انظروا إلى أصحاب الأخدود.
Then Allah tells us to look at the people of the trench.
هذا المحور الثالث.
This is the third topic.
أصحاب الأخدود ما بين كونهم شاهدين ومشهودين.
Because they were also of those two types of people, those two categories, either witnesses or witnessed upon.
لقد كانوا شاهدين لتعذيب المؤمنين.
Those who witnessed, those who were the witnesses, were the ones who were punishing the believers.
قتل أصحاب الأخدود.
Allah says that they were killed, the people of the trench.
أي لعن أصحاب الأخدود.
Or meaning the people who dug those trenches are cursed.
النار ذات أي أصحاب النار عندما أوقدوا النيران لتعذيب المؤمنين النار ذات الوقود.
Those people who lit the fire and fueled the fire to punish the believers.
إذ هم عليها قعود ينظرون إلى المؤمنين كيف يعذبون.
Whilst they were sitting and watching what was going on, the punishment of the believers.
وهم على ما يفعلون بالمؤمنين شهود.
And they are witnesses over that which they did towards the believers.
ما السبب ما نقموا منهم إلا يؤمنوا بالله العزيز الحميد.
Why do they punish and torture those people, burn them alive? Allah says the only reason is because they believed in Allah alone.
الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض.
The one to whom dominion of the heavens and the earth belongs.
والله على كل شيء شهيد.
And Allah is a witness over everything.
كانوا شاهدين لتعذيب المؤمنين.
They were witnesses to the persecution of the believers.
فيشهد العالم يوم القيامة عقوبة هؤلاء أصحاب الأخدود.
So on the day of judgment, the rest of creation will bear witness to the punishment of those people who dug those trenches and punished those believers.
إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات.
Allah says that indeed those who tested and tried the believing men and women.
ثم لم يتوبوا.
And then they didn't repent.
فلهم عذاب جهنم.
For them is the punishment of the fire.
ولهم عذاب الحريق.
And they will have a burning punishment.
سيحتشد العالم لرؤية عقوبة هؤلاء الناس الذين عاقبوا المؤمنين.
And so Allah will make all of the creation witnesses against those people who punish those believers.
المحور الرابع.
The fourth topic.
عظم الجزاء الإلهي المشهود يوم القيامة.
The greatness of the recompense or the reckoning of Allah on the day of judgment.
سيشاهد العالم كله. سيشاهد العقوبة والثواب يوم القيامة.
Because everyone will bear witness to Allah's reward and punishment on that day.
فهذه العقوبة الإلهية والانتقام الإلهي للكفار سيشهده الناس.
This divine punishment that Allah will give to the disbelievers will be witnessed. ويشهده
الجن والإنس.
And it will be witnessed by the humans and the jinn.
كما مرت الآية السابقة.
As Allah mentioned in the previous verse.
من الذين فتنوا المؤمنين ثم لم يتوبوا فلهم عذاب جهنم.
Then indeed those who tested and tried the believing men and women and didn't repent, they will have the punishment of the fire.
وسيشهد العالم ثواب أهل الإيمان.
And likewise, all of the creation will bear witness to the reward of the believers.
أهل التوحيد.
The people of Tawheed.
إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات.
Allah says, indeed, those who believed and did righteous deeds.
لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار.
For them are gardens under which rivers flow.
ذلك الفوز الكبير.
That is the greatest of success.
ثم بين الله عز وجل في هذا المحور.
And then Allah سبحانه وتعالى mentioned in this topic regarding this topic.
عظم الجزاء الإلهي المشهود في الدنيا قبل يوم القيامة.
The greatness of Allah's divine reckoning in this world before the next.
إن بطش ربك لشديد العقوبة الإلهية في الدنيا شديدة.
Indeed Allah says indeed the punishment of your Lord is severe.
فالأمر بيده كله.
Because Allah controls everything. But Allah is the one who begins and the one who repeats. And He is the one who will create the people in this life, or He creates the people and then He will resurrect them in the next. But just as His punishment is severe, He is also most merciful, most loving. For He is the owner of the mighty throne. Allah Azza wa Jalla, to Him belongs all honor and nobility. And likewise, His throne is noble. He does as He pleases, subhanahu wa ta'ala.
إذن عظم الجزاء الإلهي.
And so therefore it is the greatness of, or the gravity, the severity of the greatness of Allah's divine recompense.
المشهود في هذه الدنيا.
And it is something which will be witnessed by all.
المحور الخامس.
The fifth topic.
الشهود الأخروي أعظم من الشهود الدنيوي مهما عظم هذا الشهود.
The exposure of the next life is far worse than the exposure of this life, no matter how great that exposure may seem in this life.
ضرب الله عز وجل مثالين.
Allah Azza wa Jal gave us two examples of this.
فراعنة وقوم ثمود.
The people of Pharaoh and the people of Thamud.
أما عاقب الله عز وجل فرعون وقومه.
Didn't Allah Azza wa Jal punish the people of Pharaoh?
وشاهده بنو إسرائيل بأم عيونهم.
And the people of Bani Israel were witnessing, they were witnesses to the punishment of Pharaoh.
وإلى يومنا هذا الناس تشاهد جثة فرعون الذي قد غرق.
Until this day, we still have the remnants of Pharaoh. His body is preserved in a museum.
هذا شهود عظيم في الدنيا.
This is a witness that is great in this life.
للبطش الإلهي لهؤلاء غير الموحدين.
It is something that all can witness of the punishment of Allah in this life.
وكذلك قوم ثمود.
And likewise, the people of Thamud.
إلى يومنا هذا الكل يمر على ديار ثمود.
Because till this day, you can pass by their dwellings.
فالكل شاهد الآن أو يشاهد. نتيجة عقوبة قوم ثمود.
And we can still see how Allah punished and destroyed their people because their residences are still there.
فالشهود الأخروي أعظم من هذا الشهود الدنيوي.
But the exposure of the next life will be far greater and worse than this one.
هل أتاك حديث الجنود؟
Allah says, has there come to you the story of the soldiers of the armies?
فرعون وثمود.
The people of Pharaoh and Thamud.
فالعقوبة الأخروية أعظم شهودا من عقوبة الدنيا.
But the exposure of the next life is greater than the one of this life.
المحور السادس.
The sixth topic.
الجميع مفضوح عند الله عز وجل.
That everyone is exposed before Allah عز وجل.
فالله عز وجل يعلم بأنهم مكذبون.
Allah knows that those people rejected and denied.
وأن التكذيب ليس عن حقيقة.
And that this denial was not true in reality, meaning that they
يعلمون الحق ولكنهم يظهرون بأنه لم يظهر لهم الحق.
They know the truth in reality, but they just didn't accept it.
وإذا قال الله عز وجل بل الذين كفروا في تكذيب.
And that is why Allah says that those who disbelieve are in denial.
والله من ورائهم محيط. And الله عز وجل محيط ويعلم حقيقة الأمر.
And Allah has encompassed them. He knows their reality.
وكذلك الكفار وقريش في تكذيب مستمرون في التكذيب.
And likewise, the case was with the kuffar of Quraysh.
لم ينتفعوا من قصص ثمود وفرعون.
They didn't take benefit from the stories of Pharaoh and Thamud.
بل استمروا في التكذيب.
But they continued in their denial.
بل الذين كفروا في تكذيب.
And that is why Allah says that the disbelievers are in denial.
والله من ورائهم محيط.
And Allah has surrounded them.
لا يخرجون عن قبضة الله وعن بطش الله.
They can never escape Allah's grasp and Allah's punishment.
أعمالهم كلها محفوظة في اللوح المحفوظ.
Their actions have all been preserved.
وهم يكذبون بالقرآن.
But they disbelieve and reject the Quran.
ويكذبون ما في القرآن.
And they reject what is in the Quran.
ويكذبون على من نزل عليه القرآن.
And they reject the one upon whom the Quran was revealed.
والقرآن مجيد.
And that is why Allah says that the Quran is noble.
متناهٍ في العظمة.
It is great.
تكذيبهم لا اعتبار له.
And the denial of it has no significance.
ولا حقيقة له.
Nor is there any truth to it.
وكما أن القرآن محفوظ في اللوح المحفوظ أعمالهم كذلك محفوظة في اللوح المحفوظ.
And just as the Quran has been preserved in the preserved tablet, then likewise the actions have already been recorded.
وهذا الذي أخبرنا به من أن كل عمل وكل أمة ستكون شاهدة ومشهودة.
So this, what Allah عز وجل informed us, that every single person will bear witness on the day of judgment.
ذكره الله عز وجل في القرآن.
Allah عز وجل mentions this in the Quran.
في هذه السورة.
In this surah.
وهو قرآن مجيد متحقق ولا بد.
So this is the Quran that is noble and it is full of truth.
وهو محفوظ في اللوح المحفوظ.
And it is preserved in the preserved tablet.
وهذا الأمر بأن كل عبد شاهد شاهد ومشهود محفوظ في القرآن ومحفوظ في اللوح المحفوظ.
And likewise, this theme that every person is either a witness to witnessed upon, it is also preserved in the Quran and the preserved tablet.
فهذا الأمر لا مرية فيه.
So there can be no doubt regarding this.
بل هو قرآن مجيد.
But rather, this is the noble Quran.
في لوح المحفوظ مكتوب في اللوح المحفوظ.
Preserved in the preserved tablet.
فهذه الحقيقة التي ذكرها الله عز وجل كلها حقيقة لا مرية فيها ومحفوظة في القرآن ومحفوظة في اللوح المحفوظ.
So all of this is something which is a reality in which there is no doubt, preserved in the Quran, preserved in the preserved tablet. Make adhan. Adhan. Half ten. Okay. If you say half ten, then that means we're going to go. Iqama, Sheikh. Iqama. 10:40.
الآن إذا علمنا إخواني بأن كل عبد شاهد ومشهود فاضح ومفضوح يوم القيامة.
So now that we know that every servant is either a witness or witnessed upon.
وليعلم العبد بأن كل شيء سيشهد عليه يوم القيامة.
And we know that everything will bear witness on the day of judgment.
ويشهد له يوم القيامة.
And everything will bear witness on the day of judgment.
إذن كل شيء سيشهد لك أو عليك.
So everything will be a witness either for you or against you on the day of judgment.
ومن أجل هذا أتت سورة الطارق بعدها.
And that is why we have then the next surah, سورة الطارق.
وسورة الطارق تتكون من عدة محاور.
And سورة الطارق consists of a number of topics.
كل شيء سيشهد العبد يوم القيامة ويشهد عليه.
And that is that everything will bear witness against for you or against you on the day of judgment.
المحور الأول.
The first topic in this surah.
كل من اطلع عليك مهما بعد سيشهد لك أو عليك.
Everyone who sees you, whether they are close to you or far from you, distance from you, they will be a witness for you or against you.
والسماء والطارق.
And that is what Allah says, and takes an oath by the heavens and the coming of the night.
المحور الثاني.
The second topic.
الملائكة ستشهد لك أو عليك.
The angels will bear witness for you or against you.
المحور الثالث.
The third topic.
أعضاؤك ستشهد لك أو عليك.
Your limbs, your body will bear witness for you or against you.
المحور الرابع.
The fourth topic.
قلبك سيشهد لك أو عليك.
Your heart will bear witness against you or for you.
المحور الخامس.
The fifth topic.
كل ما علاك أو دناك سيشهد لك أو عليك.
Everything that is above you or beneath you will also bear witness for you or against you.
المحور السادس.
And the sixth topic.
هذا الأمر وهذا القول فصل بأن كل شيء سيشهد لك أو عليك.
And this is the divine command of Allah that everything will bear witness for you or against you.
لو أتينا المحور الأول.
So now let's go back to that first topic.
عرفنا المقصد كل شيء سيشهد لك أو عليك.
We know that this is the theme of the surah. Everything will bear witness for you or against you.
والسماء والطارق.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath by the heavens and the night comer.
السماء هي علتك تعلوك.
The heavens is above you.
وما هو الطارق؟
What is the طارق؟
وما أدراك ما الطارق؟
Allah says and what will make you know what is the طارق؟
النجم الثاقب. النجم الذي ضوءه يثقبك حتى يصل إليك.
It is the piercing star, the shooting star.
كأنه يخترق شدة ظلمة الليل حتى يصل إليك.
It is as if it pierces the darkness of the night till you see it or it comes to you.
فهذا النجم يكشفك.
So likewise, that star is exposing you.
وسيشهد لك وعليك يوم القيامة.
And it will be a witness for you or against you.
إذن هذا المحور الأول.
This is the first topic.
المحور الثاني.
The second topic.
الملائكة ستشهد لك وعليك.
The angels will either be a witness for you or against you.
إن كل نفس لما عليها حافظ.
Allah says that every soul has a watcher over it.
فالملائكة تحفظ عملك وتكتب عملك.
Because the angels are recording and preserving your actions and your deeds.
ستشهد لك وعليك.
So then they will also bear witness either for you or against you.
أعضاؤك ستشهد لك وعليك.
Your limbs will testify for you or against you.
فلينظر الإنسان مما خلق.
And that is what Allah says. Then let man look at what he was created from.
الله عز وجل يعلم أصل خلقك.
Because Allah knows our origin.
ويعلم موضع خروج هذه النطفة.
And he knows where that sperm drop came from, emanated from.
ويعلم انتقالها.
and he knows its journey where it went.
فلينظر الإنسان مما خلق.
And that is where Allah says, let that person look at what he was created from.
خلق الماء دافق أي منصب ويندفع بقوة.
He was created from a fluid that was ejected.
يخرج من بين الصلب والترائب ما بين العمود الفقري وما بين الأضلاع أضلاع.
That fluid emanates from between the backbone and the ribs.
الله عز وجل يعلم مرور هذه النطفة.
Allah knows the journey and the path of that fluid.
إنه على رجعه لقادر.
So therefore, Allah is all able to make that person return.
يبعثك يوم القيامة.
Meaning, He can resurrect him.
هذه الأعضاء ستشهد لك أو عليك.
These limbs that Allah is referring to, these parts of the body, these organs, they will also be a witness for you or against you.
هل استعملتها في الحرام أم في المباح؟
Did you use them in good, in what is permissible or what is impermissible?
هذا المحور الثالث.
This is the third topic.
أعضاؤك ستشهد لك أو عليك.
That your limbs will either testify for you or against you.
هل مارسه بزنا أم مارسه بمباح؟
Did you use your limbs and your organs to do good or did you use them for evil and haram?
المحور الرابع.
The fourth topic.
قلبك سيشهد لك وعليك.
Your heart will either be a witness for you or against you.
يوم تبلى السرائر أي تنكشف هذه القلوب.
Allah says on the day the roll of the secrets will be exposed.
والسرائر الأعمال المخفية كذلك تنكشف.
And السرائر everything all of your actions that were hidden will be exposed.
قلبك يشهد لك وعليك.
And therefore your heart will either be a witness for you or against you.
حين لا تستطيع أن تدفع الشهادة كل هذه الشهادات.
So you will not be able to reject all of these different testimonies that come against you. And that is why Allah says, then there will be no help or no power remaining for you. The fifth topic. Everything that is above you or is beneath you
ستشهد لك وعليك.
Will also bear witness either for you or against you.
وإذا قال الله عز وجل والسماء ذات الرجع.
And that is what Allah سبحانه وتعالى says and takes an oath by the heavens.
ما معنى ذات الرجع؟
What does it mean ذات الرجع؟
قال بعض العلماء المفسرون أي المطر يذهب إلى السماء ثم يرجع إلى الأرض.
It is said that it is the cycle of the rain cycle, that the water evaporates to the heavens and then it comes down again.
وقال بعضهم كل ما يرجع يذهب إلى السماء ويرجع منها.
Another said, it is everything, not just the rain, everything that goes up and then comes back down. The Sheikh said, how do you speak on the phone? What's the technology involved? It is waves that are passed by. These will also testify for you or against you.
عن طريق تردد هذه الموجات الصوتية تسمع الأصوات وعن طريق الموجات الصوتية ترى كذلك الصور.
It is because of these waves and signals that are sent that you can see and that you can hear from great distances.
بس والسماء ذات الرجع.
And so Allah takes an oath by the heavens and that which it brings.
هذه أقمار صناعية ربما كانت تشهد لك وعليك.
And likewise, they will testify for you or against you.
والأرض ذات الصدع.
And likewise, the earth and all it contains.
تتصدع فيخرج منها ما يخرج.
Because the earth opens up and its vegetation comes forth.
وقال بعضهم الصدع أي تجهر الأرض.
And others said that it is everything that emanates from the earth.
وتشهد من عمل صالحا وعمل سيئا له أو عليه.
And that earth will bear witness for everything that took place upon it, either for or against.
كما قال الله عز وجل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فاصدع بما تؤمر أي اجهر بما تؤمر.
And that is why Allah Azza wa Jalla told the Prophet ﷺ, be open in what you have been commanded to do.
كذلك الأرض تحدث أخبارها.
And likewise, the earth will tell its news on that day.
فتشهد لك أو عليك.
And it will testify for or against you.
وهذا القول فصل لا مرية فيه.
And that is why Allah then says that this is the command that must come to pass.
وحدانية الله قول فصل لا مرية فيه.
So the command to worship Allah alone is divine. There is no doubt in it.
وقيام الشهداء لك أو عليك قول فصل لا مرية فيه.
And the command of Allah that things will witness for you or against you is also divine. There is no doubt in it.
ويفصل الله عز وجل في هذه الشهادة قول فصل لا مرية فيه.
And Allah will judge based upon that testimony in which there will be no doubt.
ليس بالهزل.
It is not a joke.
هم يكيدون.
Those people, they plot and plan.
والسكيد هو السعي بطريق خفي إلى لإيصال الشيء إلى الغير.
And a plot and a plan is when a person tries to hide and they try to plan against you or plot against you.
يسعون لإبطال التوحيد.
They plan and plot to destroy التوحيد.
ويكيدون لإظهار بأنه لم يتضح لهم الحق.
and they pretend that they can't or they don't see or know the truth.
وأكيد كيدا.
And Allah says, and I also plot and plan.
وكل شيء سيشهد له سيشهد عليهم أو لهم.
Because everything will be a witness for them or against them.
فعليك بالتأني والتمهل.
So be patient and be calm.
وأنظرهم ولا تستعجل عليهم.
And be patient, wait, and don't be hasty with regards to them.
إنهم يكيدون كيدا وأكيد كيدا.
Allah says they plot and plan, and I plot and plan.
فمهل الكافرين.
So wait with the disbelievers, be patient with them.
أمهلهم رويدا أي أجلهم.
And be patient, give them time.
فإنه ستقوم الشهادة لهم أو عليهم.
Because everything will testify either for them or against them.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن